Hey guys, in this tutorial, we are going to implement a car price prediction of old cars in machine learning. This model predicts the price of the old car with the help of the few parameters like year, selling price, present price, kilometer driven, fuel type, etc. Okay, so let's start the project. So first of all, import all the required libraries like pandas, NumPy, datetime, seaborn, matplotlib, etc. Okay, then load our data, then show the top 5 rows of data, then perform the exploratory data analysis, and in EDA firstly check the shape of the data. Here 301 are rows and 9 are features, columns. Okay, then check the unique values of some features like fuel type, cylinder type, transmission, owner. Okay, then check that there is null value present or not. So you can see there is no null value. Then describe the data. Describe data shows that count of data, minimum value, standard deviation, minimum value, max value. Okay, then drop the car name which is of no use. Then find the current year for calculating the year difference between the older car's year and the current year to get how many years the car is old. Okay, then make a new feature number underscore of underscore year from the existing feature year. This feature is a difference between the current year and the older car's year, which return how many years the car is old in integer number 4, 5, 7, 8. Okay, then drop the year feature which is of no longer used. Then show the top 5 rows of data. Then apply the one hot encoding to convert the categorical features into the numeric features. Okay, then visualize the data using the seaborn function pair plot. Okay, then check the correlation of the data using the heat map. Okay, then prepare the data. Now split the data into the dependent and independent features. X stores our all independent features and Y stores our dependent features. Okay, then split the data into training and testing. Then shuffle the data. Then check the shape of the data. Now apply a hyperparameter tuning on the random forest regressor. We define here some parameters of the random forest like an estimator, max features, max depth, etc. Okay, then make a dictionary of these parameters. Okay, then define our random forest regressor and define a randomized search CV for hyperparameter tuning, and it contains some parameters like our estimator is our model object, then param distribution is a dictionary. Then scoring is based on the negative mean square error. Then n iter is equal to n 10 into 5. Total fits are 50. Okay. CV stands for cross validation. Verbos is used for show the information. Random state is used for randomly select the data. And jobs is used for select complete information. Okay. Then fit data. Train model on using the X train and Y train. Then predict the data using the predict the model using the X test. Then check the R2 score of our model. So you can see 96% is a very good score. Then visualize the actual and predicted data. You can see it's a correct predicted. Then display the actual and predicted data in the form of data frame. So you can see here it's a very less difference between them. Then import the pickle library and save our model car price prediction model.pkl. Okay, thank you. And I also deployed this model using the Python framework Flask, which provides some tools to implement a web application. Okay, so this is a car price prediction model. Like if I fill these fields with the help of some parameters like 2015 and price 5 lakh car, price of car is 5 lakh, showroom price. Okay. Then how many kilometers they want? Like 5,000, 50,000. Then how much owners previously had the car? Like first owner. Okay. Then fuel type is a petrol. Dealer is a individual. Manual car. Then calculate the selling price. Okay. So you can see 2,31,000 of our car price. Okay. Now, if you are interested in machine learning, deep learning, natural language processing, Flask, Python, so you can follow this blog. Here I upload different projects here. So you can follow this blog. And if you need this project and how to run this project, how to download this project, so you can visit here. Here you will get all the information. Okay. So thank you guys. If we will meet you in the next project. Thank you.